This One News update is brought to you by ANZ. We live in your world.
New Plymouth police have arrested several Greenpeace activists, including the actress Lucy Lawless, who have been staging an environmental protest on an oil drilling ship. We're joined now by phone by One News reporter John Newton at the port of Taranaki. John.
Hi. Well, we've seen the police go partway up the tower ladder this morning, and as a result of that, nearly all of the protesters have slowly come down. There are, in fact, some still up there. I can see one partway down at the moment. As we watched the Noble Explorer from the wharf gates this morning, all six of the protesters camped on their small platform near the top of the drilling tower, suddenly climbed right up to the top of the tower framework. That's 53 metres, 160 feet above the deck of the boat. And from where I was standing, I could see the tiny form silhouetted against a clear blue sky. Greenpeace says the protesters were all wearing harnesses and would have remained clipped into the structure, which is just as well because there's quite a wind out here at the moment. However, once all the protesters are down, which should be within the next half an hour to an hour, police say they'll be taken to New Plymouth Police Station, where a decision will be made about any charges to be laid against them. The drill ship was due to leave port yesterday to drill wells off the coast of Alaska, and once the protesters have disembarked, it's expected it'll get away as soon as possible.
Thank you. That's John Newton from New Plymouth.
This One News update is brought to you by ANZ. We live in your world.
Thanks for coming down.
Have you got anything you'd like to say, Lucy?
Well, we had a couple of thoughts, didn't we, Viv?
Yep, just getting some thoughts together on our way out of the police station. So we're really proud to have held up that ship for as long as we possibly could. Every hour that we were up there was an hour that that ship was not on its way to the Arctic to start drilling for oil.
And when we started, seven of us went up the rig, but 133,000 people came down with us in solidarity. They've been writing letters, and we know that new heroes are going to spring up in our fervent mission to make sure that the oil industry becomes an energy industry that is renewable and clean, and so that all life on the planet will prosper. We have the technology and the know-how to have a clean energy economy, but it's being withheld from us. So we are asking, inviting big oil companies into the 21st century to provide the kind of leadership in the energy field that we need.
Would you do it again?
That's it. Thank you, everybody. We're hungry, right, Mike?
Woohoo! Yeah.